أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شهادة تنجي قائلها من عذاب أليم، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الميامين. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: وما هذه الحياة الدنيا إلا لهو ولعب وإن الدار الآخرة لهي الحيوان لو كانوا يعلمون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We understand the time which we are in as Muslims, worldwide, internationally, individually. And today, I would like to try my level best to talk about life. As my brother, he put it clearly, that the life of Muslims today. Sometimes explaining the life of Muslims of today, it may help, but it may help less if we don't define what life is. It happened that we are in the class and we are trying to find out what is life. When I asked the brothers who are in the class, I found it out that each and everyone had his own description of life. But in the end, we all had one thing in common. And what is that? Because if someone says life, we have been taught a life to be condemned. Sometimes when we read Quran, we misunderstand, or we translate it, or we have been taught other way, that life is something which we must not actually pay attention at all. When we come to the Quran, it says, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Anyone who will try to explain life, he will show us how dangerous life it is. But in the same time, when we go deeper, we find out that, oh, someone can ask, what is the main issue of us talking about life? Brothers and sisters, fortunately, or unfortunately, the way you define life in within yourself, that's how you live. Some of us, we are living according to the weekends. We work from Monday to Friday, then Saturday to go together, driving together motorbikes, or sitting together, smoking that things of gold called habla mabla, what. Then that is life. Then starting to talk ill about each other and starting to be proud of how much I make a year, how much I do, whatever. Is that is a life? What is life? Oh, someone have defined life for you. The way you see someone, how he live, that is what it called life. My brothers and sisters, fortunately, one of the mysterious creation of Allah, it is the creation called life. How mysterious it is, because of each and every one of us, we are living according to the way we define life. Even if you never define it, but your way of living, it tells us how do you understand life. But now, because Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, Allah sent him to us as a mercy to all mankind. He did not leave anything without explaining it, so that in the end of the day we can be beneficial. When we go into Quran and we need to find out what life is, Then Allah says in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. In that verse, we understand that this thing called life, it is a creation of Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala. It's Allah who created this structure called life, the way He created the other structure called death. Allah started with something about Alladhi khalaqa al-mauta, the one who created death. After death, then He said, Wal hayat, and life. Amazingly, my brothers and sisters, that we as human beings, the same amount which we know about life is the same amount, is the same percentage which we have about death. If you can ask me, or I can ask you, how much you know about life? You may assume that you know what life is. I may assume so. But only to find out these two structures, one structure called death, and another structure called life. The same amount which you and I may know about life is the same amount which you and I know about death. What do you know about life? What do I know about life? If you could ask me, what do I know about life? I know nothing except the past. Because I have passed, Mali, I know about the past. From the past up to today, if I'm 43, if I'm 45, if I'm 42, I don't know. Because if you are born under the tree and there was no registration, then it's hardly to know exactly which month and which year you were born. Unless your parents tell you it was raining or it was doing this and whatever. It's not a big deal about that. But the main issue is that life, what I know about it is what I have spent. What do I know about the life of the future? Nothing. I don't know that now I'm here, I'm going to perform Salat al-Jumu'ah, I'm going to learn from the Sheikh about the khutbah, whatever, but I don't know that I will be able to perform Salat al-Asr. I don't know at all. I will be guessing that insha'Allah, that's it, insha'Allah, I will perform Salat al-Asr. Insha'Allah, I will perform Salat al-Maghrib. But what do I know? I know the past about the life, but about the future, I don't know. About the death, what do we know about the death? Same apply. You can only know death after you are dead. But who dead and come back and tell us exactly what happened in the grave? So we can only know about the death according to what we have learned from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when it comes to life, we only know what we have spent so far. But we don't know what is coming. That is the mysteriousness, and that's what makes life very interesting in itself. Now Allah is telling us, Alladhi khalaqa al-mauta wal hayata, is the one who created that structure called death, and is the one who created that structure called life. Liyabluwakum. So that He can put us on the trial, who can excel to move towards Him. Because remember, what He says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. He did not create us, neither other creation which we don't know, among of them is Majinni, except to save Him. So now, He gave us this thing, this structure called life, so that we can excel, who will excel, to run towards Him, Allah, and Allah alone, Tabaraka Ta'ala. My brothers and my sisters there, how important this life is. What is this life? Maybe look at it in this form. These things, this structure called life, is when Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala, He says, He told the angel, what Allah says, wa idh qala rabbuka lil malaika. Remember when Allah told the angel, inni khaliqukum basharan min salsalin min hamain masnun. I'm creating a human being in the dark clay, in the soil. فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. The minute I complete him, and I put in him that thing called life, what you have to do? You have to bow to him. We thought, or we are thinking, that it only ended up then. That angel bowed to you, to your father Adam, then. But it's not really meaning to make sujood to the angel. The angel to make sujood to Adam. No. It means that the importance of this life, when it is there in you and I, the angel going to be, as long as it's inside there, they'll be remaining working for you, working on you. In order for them to save Allah, they must save Allah through you. That's why you have Atidu and you have Raqib. That's why you have the angel who الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ. Those who are handling the arsh of Allah, وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. They are still asking on behalf of those who understand the importance of life. So this is the life which we are talking about. That if maybe we have been told and taught that life is a bad thing and whatever all over. No, it's very important. The only problem when the life can become a problem, it is when you make it become a hadaf. What is the hadaf? Meaning when it become, when you fail to make it wasila. That it is the means which you have to use in order to reach Allah and Allah alone. In another form, to show the importance of life is that if you never lived, if you never got life, we don't know if you will get paradise. So in order for you to get Jannah, you must get these things called life. So this life, the way you use it, it will make you to end paradise or it will make you to end hell. That's how important that structure is called life. But don't make it to be hadaf. The problem which we have, when Allah talk about lahun wa la'bun wa zinatan wa takathur bil awlad, Allah is telling us when now you think that when you have it, you have arrived. That's when now it can turn to become وَمَا الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. But the structure called life is very, very important. How important is it to you and I? Brothers and sisters, you see the hobo when you pass. A hobo person, you ask, do you have real life? I don't have life somehow, somewhere. You may assume, we may think so. But let, without his awareness, he hear the gun. Someone shot a gun. What's he going to do? He'll be running. Well, so what are you running? Hey, I'm trying to save my life. So even a hobo, he still likes that thing called life. Even you and I, we still need that thing called life. So life is very important. How important is it? I say it's a mysterious. Because this is a creation of Allah, which Allah tells us in the Quran, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنْ عِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. We have very little knowledge which we know about it. In that, what we do, we have to subtract and to add, to find out that structure, what it has exactly. So that, inshallah, by understanding it, and we do accordingly, maybe when the mercy of Allah reached those who are really deserving it, as one of the awliya, Muhammad al-Bosir, what he says, لَعَلَّ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّي حِينَ يَقْسِيمُهَا تَأْتِ عَلَى الْحَسَبِ عِسْيَانِكَ اللَّمَمِ. So maybe on that time, when Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give paradise to only those who deserve it, accidentally will come to you due to the effort which we are trying to do. So now, we need to understand this creation called life. Brothers and sisters, when I read in Quran, remember we are from Ramallah, we said in Quran, I found out that this structure have four rooms, or contain with the four departments. One department is spiritual. Life is contained spiritual, and another department is social. 25% social, 25% spiritual. Then we have got 50%. This structure called life, it has mental. Another structure called mental. When you put mental, it becomes 75. Then we need another 25. The 25, that is physical. So this life, this structure, is a physical body.
Because without this physical body, then you become mayit, you separated, you have to be buried, you have to do whatever. So there's a physical, there's mental, there's spiritual, and there's social. That is life. When you have them 25, then you get 100%. Why Muslim we are suffering? Why Muslim we meet ourselves, we can't be on top. And Allah says, wa antum a'launa in kuntum mu'minin. You are on top, we have to be on top. Our biggest problem, we don't balance. You need to balance in life. You have to be spiritual 25, don't go beyond. That's why, as much as we are in Ramadan, spiritual Ramadan, you can go, not go beyond 10 days in itikaf. Beyond 10 days is what? Is now you are in the destructive. If you go beyond 25% of the spiritual, this is exactly why you see that Muslims, we misunderstood life somehow before. And what we did, we concentrated too much in the Al-Fatiha and Yasin, Alif Lam Mim, a lot. And we got a lot of Maulanas. Now we have a lot of Maulana, including myself, maybe I'm Maulana, I don't know. We got a lot of Maulana, we have no jobs. Since we have no jobs, what's going to happen? I'm now going to start to fight Maulana. Maulana is going to start fight me. We're going to start to come with the groups, with whatever. Why? Because physically, there's nothing I can do. I'm a Maulana, I can't even change a tire of my own car. Why? Because I was too much sitting from morning to evening in the house that learning, or in Jamia, or in the Madarasa. We failed to balance Muslims. We failed to balance life. Then you find out physically there are those who went beyond the limitation. Among of them, well-known youth, you know, what? I don't know. You know this English, I don't know it. But he ever exercised until he died, this Chinese guy. So also exercise physically. You can only go up to 25%. Social, you need only 25%. Mentally, if you go beyond 25%, you don't fit to be in the community. Where do you fit? You must go to the psychiatry. Something is wrong with this person. He was too much mathematical, now he's off. So brothers and sisters, we need balance. But what can bring balance in life? The driving force of this life is the two opponents. One is the thinking, and another one is hope. Thinking and hope, when you bring together in that structure, because you must remember, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he taught us, he says, thinking one hour, is better than worshipping Allah 1 year, day and night. The importance of thinking. So this structure, what we need thinking. Thinking of what? Because there's a certain promise which Allah promised you, that if you can obey Him, He's going to give you what? Peace. Al-Jannah. That Jannah, there's nothing inside except peace and other things which our mind never came across. So now, for us to reach, to be able to balance, we need to think deeply. Right now, what? We need a think tank, which can come up with a solution. What a solution? How much are we really undermined as Muslims? Don't you really worry about that? Where are we as Muslims? See our number. But really, who's really suffer? What is the highest number of the refugee on the earth today? Imagine CRS, Central Africa, it was being rubbed off completely. Why? Because wa ma naqamu minhum illa an yu'minu billahi al-aziz al-hamid. Nowadays, Muslims, where are we really? The main issue is we need a think tank. We need to go deeper and say, what is the solution? Because you must remember, from the day you were born, not even before you were born, before your father Adam, when you were after your forefather Adam, what happened? Remember that covenant. When the Shaitan says,
لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ.
Remember, since then, always there is wars. Don't think what you see in the Central Africa, what you see in Sudan, what you see in Palestine, what you see in Libya or in Tunisia, what you see, don't think, hey, really in it. No, even your grandfathers, their time also was waste according to their time. So as long as we are living, again, our children also, they will be also with some time also. It will be a hard time to them. But now, what is happening? The issue is our forefathers, they outsmarted us. It meaning that they managed, they won the war. But we, what's happening? We are really losing the war. How are we losing the war, brothers and sisters? In this situation which we are in today. When you face your enemy, you don't know exactly what your enemy have. That's why in the each and every government, the most critical department is intelligence. What's the job of it? They need to know the enemy, what he have. Now, what is happening? They do it deliberately. And they say, let us kill the Palestine. And what happened? We come up. Mudahara, we are in a strike, protesters, they just burn the flag, they just do what? After that, Habibi, what is happening? You just start to show, who's this one? Oh, who's this one? Who's this one? But in the end, what is happening? That is a statistic, is a trick of the war, my brothers and sisters. We need to sit down. The war are not won in the battlefield today. In the Midan, I've got Midan. It is not worthy. The war are won in the room there, when they are busy coming with a strategy. How are we going to win our enemy? So that is the thing which we need. We need to go deeper. Is it really what we are doing? Is it really effective? Or it is ineffective? Because Shaitan can do it more. He said, okay, let them come more and more in the protest. So that what happened? After that, they'll be tired. Really, you'll be tired. If you jump, toy, toy, after that, you can't even get a gun to fight, brothers. So we need to think. This structure called life, in order for us to balance. And I said, hope. With hope of what? Whichever time which has come to you. There are two types of thinking, brothers and sisters. Islamically or Quranically. What Quran says, wa nafsin wa ma sawaha. Allah created that soul perfectly. What he says, fa'alhamaha fujuraha wa taqwaha. The soul, Allah put the inspiration. Each and every thing which comes to you, it is in two ways. Either is ilham, inspiration from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, or is ilwa, destruction, how to self-destruct yourself. That's how, again, now, in order for you and I to understand that structure called life, that life, it needs a roof, that structure. Because we have seen the wall, we have seen the mixture, the cement and the sand, which is hope and thinking. Now, we need the roof of that structure called life to be completed. And that is nothing else except hidayah, guidance. We need guidance, my brothers and sisters, in order for us to win, as our forefather made it. How do we know that our forefathers made it when this place is full? When we see ourselves is full like that, really they made it. They made a da'wah. They may not be knowing a lot of verse of Quran, but they have made it. Today, alhamdulillah, you see the place is full. In my mosque in Harambe is full. Everywhere in Harambe is full. So they have made it. Now, what is happening to you and I? Are we taking it further or are we going down with that structure? So we need hidayah. This is the time for you and I, brothers and sisters, when you stand up and you perform and you recite either tahiyyat al-masjid, those two rak'ah of the salah, which when you enter the mosque, or another sunnah with the faradah which you perform, when you come to this word, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, mean it. Allah, please guide us. Otherwise, we are losing it. We don't know where we are at the moment, my brothers and sisters. We don't know. We are in the situation exactly your prophet and my prophet Musa alayhi salam was in. And that is the situation which we are in. That you must know. But you know what? Again, the bricks of that structure, it is the time. So if I claim that I'm trying to live life, then I'm stick to the time. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi al-mayamin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Firstly, we'd like to thank Mulana Ahmad Qasim for coming out today and giving us his lecture in this masjid. Did you know, every year Coca-Cola bankrolls the American Israel Chamber of Commerce Awards, which honors companies that have contributed most to the Israeli economy. In 2009, a Coca-Cola sponsored award went to the Israel's lobby, which is the AIPAC, for its lobbying of the Senate to reject the UN call for immediate ceasefire and endorse the continuation of the Israel military assault on Gaza. There are many more reasons not to consume Coca-Cola products, and that's on the notice board of this masjid. We do appeal to all businesses and individuals to stop consuming Coca-Cola products, as well as to encourage their friends and families to stop consuming these products. We would also like to congratulate the following businesses for no longer stocking Coca-Cola products, and we encourage people to continue supporting them. They are J&E Cash & Carry, Advanced Cash & Carry, Akalwaya Spices, Simply Foods, Taj Mahal Takeaways, Achi Supreet, Z Supermarket, Al Ghazali College Tuck Shop, The Golden Nest Exclusive Function Venue, Frontline Cash & Carry, Super Bake & Take, Moyadeen's Takeaways, Baker's Oven, Yusuf's Pan Shop, Salamat Supermarket, Al Asr Tuck Shop, PMT Tuck Shop, Kismet Supermarket, Easyfill Engine, Budget Supermarket, Golden Dairies, Fon Supermarket, Rana Supermarket, Spill the Beans Cafe, Maguire's Car Wash, and also Silver Crescent Gardens. Jazakallah.